to. Good evening, everyone. If you have this hymnal in your pews, the St. Michael hymnal, our opening hymn is going to be For All the Saints, number 523.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. Bienvenidos, hermanos y hermanas del movimiento de Identes, la familia de Fernando Rielo. We come together tonight with great joy and thanksgiving to celebrate now the closing of the 100th anniversary of Fernando Rielo's birth. And we have great confidence that he is praying for us in this Mass and for all of our intentions. So, brothers and sisters, let us enter with joy into this celebration by first calling to mind our sins and asking the Lord for his pardon and peace. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Cristo, ten piedad.
Cristo, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of
oh.
Let us pray. On this, the feast of Saint Andrew, we humbly implore your majesty, O Lord, that just as the blessed apostle Andrew was for your church a preacher and pastor and martyr, so he may be for us a constant intercessor before you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. There is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all, enriching all who call upon him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But how can they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how can they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone to preach? And how can people preach unless they are sent? And it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news. But not everyone has heeded the good news. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed what was heard from us? Thus faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the word of Christ. But I ask, did they not hear? Certainly they did, for their voice has gone forth to all the earth, and their words to all the ends of the world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
El mensaje del Señor resuena en toda la tierra. El mensaje del Señor resuena en toda la tierra. Los cielos proclaman la gloria de Dios y el firmamento anuncia las obras de sus manos. Un día comunica el mensaje, a otro día, y la noche lo transmite a la noche. Toda la noche el mensaje del Señor resuena en toda la tierra. Sin pronunciar una palabra, sin que repronuncien su voz, a toda la tierra llega su sonido y su mensaje hasta el fin del mundo. El mensaje del Señor resuena en toda la tierra. El mensaje del Señor resuena en toda la tierra. Resuena.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." At once, they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there and saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. Jesus called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Hay mucho tráfico en la ciudad de Nueva York, no? My goodness, a lot of traffic, but estamos aquí. Thank God we are here. Gracias a Dios. So welcome to all of you to America's Parish Church. On behalf of Cardinal Dolan, I extend my warm greetings to all of you, Edente missionaries, Edente families, Edente friends, and especially Edente youth, young people. We are gathered here tonight on the feast of St. Andrew to close the 100th anniversary of the birth of your founder, the philosopher, the poet, and the servant of God, and God willing, one day, the saint, Fernando Rielo. A warm welcome also to Father Fernando Real, the General Superior of the priestly branch of the Edente Institute, and Bishop Luis Romero, my friend and Auxiliary Bishop of Rockville Center and a member of the Edente community. With us in prayer, I'm sure, our Professor Juana Sanchez Gay Venegas, the General Superior of the Women's Branch, Dr. Luis Casasus La Torre, President and Primate of the Edente Institute. Many are with us in prayer tonight who are not here physically present. And welcome to my brother seminarians and also recently ordained Edente priests who studied at St. Joseph Seminary, where I, Bishop James Massa, serve as the rector. And to my other brother priests who are here in the sanctuary, and to my dear friend, Father Robert Badillo, who never stops plying me with articles and poems by Fernando Rielo, the go-to philosopher, spiritual writer for our time. Tonight, brothers and sisters, really is a blessing for the worldwide family of the Edente missionaries. and especially for the local communities here in the Archdiocese of New York and the Diocese of Rockville Center, the Bronx and Long Island. A centenary celebration is always special. It always marks a moment for any movement in the church to look beyond the original inspiration of the founder. What are the next steps to be taken for us? What are the next steps to be taken to live the charism in the new context in which we, the members, now find ourselves? Now, the Adentes look to 1959 as the year of the founding. 1959, that's 64 years ago. I know because I'm 63 and it's 1 year before I was born. Pope St. John the 23rd had just called the Second Vatican Council, and Europe was still recovering from the ravages of World War II. The internet, artificial intelligence, and the vast cultural changes that swept through the Western world in the 1960s were barely on the horizon. The transformations, the changes of the last 64 years, both in church and society, have given rise to a new landscape for proclaiming the gospel. But the genius of any church movement which has staying power, the genius is shown in the manner in which its founder captures the spirit of his day in setting forth a plan for bringing people to Christ, while at the same time he provides a vision that accounts for the larger epochal changes that cut across generations. My goodness, folks, we are living through a time of great change, vast epochal transformations that raise such fundamental questions as, what does it mean to be a human being? The forces unleashed by technology and medicine, combined with materialist philosophies that leave behind a Christ-centered view of the human person and of a world that is supposed to be ordered toward communion with God. Lots of challenges in this kind of environment. It leaves us with an unprecedented challenge to preach the gospel in a new way, in a different way. How do we sing the Lord's song in a strange land, was the question the psalmist raised back in the Old Testament. How do we sing the Lord's song for the people of our time? But the voices for articulating a way forward have not been lacking. We have at our disposal today nearly a century-long corpus of writings of popes and prophetic thinkers who shine the light of Christ, who shine the light of Catholic wisdom on the spiritual challenges of our age. From Pope Pius to Pope Francis, from Karl Rahner to Joseph Ratzinger, two of the great theologians, from council fathers like St. John Paul II to your own father founder, Fernando Rielo. This evolving Catholic conversation provides us with the best view of the world we can find and the surest defense of human life and human dignity. Christ proclaimed in an authentically Catholic voice continues to reveal humanity to itself and also a future that preserves human freedom, human rights, and care for our home, planet Earth. The time has never been more urgent for well-formed priests, well-formed catechists, well-formed evangelists, like those among the Identes, to lead people, especially young people, to friendship with Jesus, so that they can know the truth about themselves and the reason for the hope that is in them. Tonight's celebration coincides with the feast of a first century apostle, one of the 12, whose witness, I believe, speaks to tonight's celebration. The tradition gives Andrew the title first called, protokletos, in the Greek of the Bible. And that is because Jesus called him to be his disciple before all the others. Andrew introduces his brother Simon Peter to Jesus by saying, "Brother, we have found the Messiah. We have found the Christ." And this apostle, who like all the others, except John, shed his blood for the faith, this apostle preached the gospel to the Greek-speaking world of the Eastern Mediterranean. The Greek Orthodox honor Andrew as the founder of the Church of Constantinople, the sister church to the Church of Rome, which is, of course, our spiritual center as Catholics. Every year on this date, the Pope sends a delegation to extend fraternal wishes to the Patriarch and to offer prayers for restored unity between our two churches. Well, being first called should perhaps be a title that your father founder shares with Andrew the Apostle. Was not Fernando Rielo the first to receive the Idente charism? He's the first Idente. Did he not also become a fisher of men and women in a manner not unlike the apostle, as we heard in the gospel just read for us? After leaving the Redemptorist order, we know his story, right? After leaving the Redemptorist order in 1957, Fernando heard the voice of Jesus while driving from the airport to Santa Cruz de Tenerife in the Canary Islands. "Fernando, this is the place," the voice said to him. "This is the place I have chosen for the foundation of the Institute. This city will be your cross and your glory." Your cross and your glory. Of course, the inspiration for this great project of the Idente movement has a prehistory that stretches back to when Fernando was a little boy. A little boy defying the communist rebels who were threatening to execute him unless he renounced his Catholic faith. Remember? It was his first communion in 1930, and little Fernando found an uncommon courage to convince the militants to walk away. And then later at age 16, Fernando had the first of many, many mystical encounters that would later define his theology, his way of speaking about God and the Blessed Trinity, and his philosophy of the human person. He's a great mind, a great intellect. In the Guadarrama Mountains in Spain, the teenage Fernando heard the voice of the Heavenly Father. "Be holy, my son. Be holy as I am holy. Be holy, my son." Those words penetrated his heart. What was spoken to him personally became the basis for later discerning a mission to everyone. Fernando wrote about his response to the Heavenly Father. I promised him that I would always repent From that day onward, I would always repent of anything that displeased him and would spend my whole life seeking his will. And I began to harbor the longing that these words of the Heavenly Father would enter the hearts of all people. All people, be holy, my son, my daughter, be holy as I am holy. You know, many of the saints receive their vocation through a direct encounter with Jesus, who bestows on them a particular mission that coincides with the summons to conversion. What's unusual for Fernando Rielo is that his call came directly from God the Father, the first person of the Blessed Trinity. So let me suggest for a moment that this call from the Father harkens back to the original call, the foundational inauguration of God's plan to restore all things through his beloved Son. What am I thinking of? The baptism of Jesus in the Jordan River. Jesus becomes the truly first called, the one who grounds the possibility of any of us receiving our Christian vocation. Remember? Remember what happens after John baptizes Jesus in the Jordan River and the voice is heard from the heavens as the Spirit descends upon the Lord in the form of a dove? This is my beloved Son. This is my beloved Son with whom I am well pleased. You see, no calling in the church can exist without taking its place within this primordial, this first calling of Jesus. Only in Christ, in him, can we discover ourselves as truly beloved sons and daughters of a loving Father. Only in him who calls us to loving communion and a mission of service to our fellow human beings, only in him. For Fernando, the Father is the one who kisses each one of us into existence. What a great image that is. Kisses us into existence from the womb, from the womb. It's like Jeremiah, the prophet, hearing God say to him, "From the womb I have called you, from the womb." The voice of God has made us beloved sons and daughters. Our creation in the bodies of our mother is the first gift of the Father, as Fernando would tell us. And therefore, our lifelong task, our task in life is to acquire what Fernando calls a filial consciousness, our awareness of ourselves as beloved of the Father. And that allows us to know ourselves as having a purpose in life, as having a goodness that is irascible in our souls. We've been loved into existence. And that is how we participate here on earth in the life of the Father, who eternally gives himself over to his beloved Son in the Trinity. By the bond that is their Holy Spirit, we were created, brothers and sisters, to love and to share in the triune life of God. That's Fernando's message to us and to the whole church. Also, like Andrew the Apostle, whose feast we celebrate tonight, Fernando Rielo cast a wide net, in pursuing his calling as a founder and as a philosopher, a founder of a society of apostolic life that would eventually engage people from many different countries. Over dinner tonight, I was talking to the priests about the many countries that participate in this amazing movement, from India to Latin America to the United States to Italy, to so many countries. What a large net Fernando has cast. St. Paul says, take everyone and everything captive for Christ. And so Fernando did that as a founder, and he did it as a philosopher, engaging all the major currents of ancient, medieval, and modern philosophy, not to mention modern science. He was a genius. The distinctive character of his philosophy, what we call metaphysics, the most difficult branch of philosophy, emerged after laboring through the proposals of so many others. And in this regard, he was like the fisherman from the parable that Jesus tells in Matthew 13, who threw his nets into the sea and collected every kind of fish, but then who had to sort through to separate the good ones from the bad ones. Fernando sorted through the nets of Christian tradition and contemporary thought and took for his own scholarship what showed promise, what was worthy of being shared with others. His thought now takes its place among the philosophers who dedicated themselves to the dialogue of faith and reason. Faith and reason. That's so important for young people to discover, because there's this false notion out there in the world that somehow science contradicts faith. Absolutely not. When science is carried out according to its own proper principles, it is in harmony with our faith as Catholics. Our faith sheds a light on all disciplines, on all subject areas, a light that keeps us investigating, that keeps us inquiring, searching for truth. Well, finally, like Andrew the Apostle, our father founder carried his cross throughout the journey, cross of suffering, of suffering. And isn't that how we always see St. Andrew depicted in works of art? You see him, the image of Andrew, and he's carrying the X cross, right? The diagonal cross on which he would be crucified. And also, he carries a book. How like Fernando Rielo. As a young seminarian, he might have worn the Redemptorist cross, the cross of the Redemptorist order, with its iconic lance and sponge mounted on three hills, recalling Calvary. And later in life, especially during his long illness here in New York and Queens, Fernando bore a heavy cross, the cross of illness. And yet still he labored to give birth to this family, to this community, as an institute of pontifical right, which means it reaches its arms across the whole world. Along with the scriptures, the cross remained the lens through which Fernando envisioned the mission we are convened here tonight to honor and to celebrate. So, members of the Idente family, now we draw the centenary year to an end, grateful for what God has done through his servant Fernando and his many collaborators. We are thankful for the Idente school, Idente youth, Idente Volunteers, the Fernando Rielo Cultural Foundation, the Fernando Rielo Healthcare Association, and the recently awarded Rielo Prize for Music, and so much more. We are grateful because the fruits of this man, of his movement, abound. But in an even more profound way, we are grateful for the light that shone through him, through this saintly man. He has led us all back to our baptism and to the one calling that matters above all else, being a beloved son, a beloved daughter of the Father, on whom the Spirit of Jesus Christ descends. Let our last word be one of praise to the all-glorious Blessed Trinity, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Loving Father in heaven, we come before you confident as children in your fatherly love that your will is to provide us with the grace we need to be holy as you are holy.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for our Archbishop Timothy Cardinal Dolan, for Bishop Massa, the Bishop Luis Miguel, and for all who guide the people of God, may they be strengthened in their mission of leading us to holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For heads of state and leader, por los jefes de Estado, y líderes de todas las naciones de la tierra, para que tengan la luz y la valentía de promover la humanidad, paz, y para que la justicia y la verdad conquisten y terrorizo la persecución y la cultura de la muerte, roguemos al Señor.
Tengamos óyenos.
Para sa lahat ng kabataang naririto ngayon at sa komunidad ng ating parokya, na sila naway makinig ng mabuti sa tinig ng Diyos Ama sa langit, na sa kanila'y tumatawag sa pagkabanal at naway walang atubiling ipagkaloob ang kanilang mga sarili sa Kanya sa tunay na pag-ibig at handang iaalay ang kanilang buhay para sa kapurihan ng Ama. Manalangin tayo sa Panginoon. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ka anyị rịọ arịrịọ maka ndị nzukọ Adente. N'ụbọchị tata ka ndị nzukọ Adente na-echeta emume ahụ narị onye chọpụtara otu a. N'aha ya bụ Fernando Rielo. Ndị otu Adente na-echetakwa emume ahụ 20 Fernando Rielo hapụrụ n'ụwa. Ka anyị kpee ekpere ka Chineke gbaa ha ume, ka ha wepụta obi ha na ịfụnanya na nsọpụrụ were na-agbasa ozi ọma nke Chineke. We pray, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear our filial prayer and manifest to the world that you are all-merciful by granting these petitions, those unspoken in our hearts, and those that will now be brought to your altar. We pray in the name of Jesus, your beloved Son, our firstborn brother, and Lord forever and ever.
Thank you. Hermanos, para que este sacrificio mío de ustedes sea agradable a Dios, Padre Todopoderoso. Concédenos, Dios Todopoderoso, que te agraden estos dones que te presentamos en la festividad de San Andrés, y haz que sean para nosotros fuente de vida eterna. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you, eternal shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds, to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Santo eres en verdad, Padre, y con razón te alaban todas tus criaturas, ya que por Jesucristo tu Hijo, Señor nuestro, con la fuerza del Espíritu Santo, das vida y santificas todo, y congregas a tu pueblo sin cesar, para que ofrezca en tu honor un sacrificio sin mancha, desde donde sale el sol hasta el ocaso. Por eso, Padre, te suplicamos que santifiques por el mismo Espíritu estos dones que hemos separado para ti, de manera que se conviertan en el cuerpo y la sangre de Jesucristo, Hijo tuyo y Señor nuestro, que nos mandó celebrar estos misterios. Porque él mismo, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan, y dando gracias, te bendijo, lo partió y lo dio a sus discípulos, diciendo: tomen y coman todos de él, porque esto es mi cuerpo, que será entregado por ustedes. Del mismo modo, acabada la cena, tomó el cáliz, dando gracias, te bendijo, lo pasó a sus discípulos, diciendo: tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de la alianza nueva y eterna, que será derramada por ustedes y por muchos, para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. Este es el sacramento de nuestra fe. Así pues, Padre, al celebrar ahora el memorial de la pasión salvadora de tu Hijo, de su admirable resurrección y ascensión al cielo, mientras esperamos su venida gloriosa, te ofrecemos en esta acción de gracias el sacrificio vivo y santo. Dirige tu mirada sobre la ofrenda de tu Iglesia y reconoce en ella la víctima por cuya inmolación quisiste devolvernos tu amistad, para que fortalecidos con el cuerpo y la sangre de tu Hijo y llenos de su Espíritu Santo, formemos en Cristo un solo cuerpo y un solo Espíritu.
Que Él nos transforme en ofrenda permanente, para que gocemos de tu heredad junto con tus elegidos, con María la Virgen, Madre de Dios, su esposo San José, los apóstoles y los mártires, y todos los santos por cuya intercesión confiamos obtener siempre tu ayuda.
Te pedimos, Padre, que esta víctima de reconciliación traiga la paz y la salvación al mundo entero. Confirma en la fe y en la caridad a tu Iglesia peregrina en la tierra, a tu servidor, el Papa Francisco, a nuestro obispo Timoteo, a nuestro obispo James y a nuestro obispo Luis Miguel, al orden episcopal, a los presbíteros y diáconos y a todo el pueblo redimido por ti. Atiende los deseos y súplicas de esta familia que has congregado en tu presencia. Reúne en torno a ti, Padre misericordioso, a todos tus hijos dispersos por el mundo.
A nuestros hermanos difuntos y a cuantos murieron en tu amistad, recíbelos en tu reino, donde esperamos gozar todos juntos de la plenitud eterna de tu gloria. Por Cristo, Señor nuestro, por quien concedes al mundo todos los bienes.
Por Cristo, con Él y en Él, a ti, Dios Padre omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria, por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén, 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 amén.
Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir: Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en la tentación y líbranos del mal.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May communion and your sacraments strengthen us, O Lord, so that by the example of the blessed Apostle Andrew, we who carry in our body the death of Christ may merit to live with him in glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Kindly be seated.
Allow me a few brief words on behalf of the Idente community. Our gratitude, first of all, to our Father in Heaven, our absolute Dad, for creating us, for giving us this vocation, and for giving us our founder, Fernando Rielo. Our thanks to His Eminence Cardinal Dolan for graciously allowing us to use this wonderful cathedral every year for this commemoration. Our thanks to Bishop Massa, the rector of the seminary and head of the Bishop's Doctrine Committee of the United States Council of Catholic Bishops, to my brother, Bishop Luis, to all of my brothers and sisters here, to our wonderful school of acolytes who has come from three parishes way out on Long Island and the Bronx, and to all of you, we even have brothers here from California. Thank you for the effort you've made. And for all who have come from so far away, we only ask you to continue to pray for us to support our missions, because we need your prayers to live our vocation, as we pray for you every day. Now, Father Fernando, the General Superior of the Men's Branch of the Idente Missionaries, will say a few words in Spanish.
Solamente unas palabras muy breves en nombre de nuestro presidente, el Padre Luis Casasús, y de la Superiora General de nuestras hermanas, nuestra querida hermana Juana Sánchez, fundamentalmente, puesto que ya nuestra querida hermana Elaine ha agradecido a todos, pero yo especialmente quiero dar las gracias a Su Excelencia el Obispo James Massa, que no solo nos ha presidido en esta celebración de la Eucaristía, sino que además en sus sabias palabras de la homilía nos ha marcado a todos un camino a recorrer. Celebrar el centenario de Fernando Rielo en su nacimiento significa que un camino se abre ante nosotros. Y eso es lo que nuestro querido amigo y obispo James Massa nos ha presentado en su homilía, con su profundo conocimiento de la vida y de la obra de Fernando Rielo. Nos ha abierto a todos más claramente el horizonte de nuestro futuro. Aquí en la tierra, como miembros de esta familia idente que tienen que vivir este carisma, y nos ha abierto también el horizonte que nos espera con la gracia de Dios en la vida eterna. Muchísimas gracias, Excelencia.
Muchísimas gracias, Padre, por sus palabras. And thank you to all of you for coming tonight to this beautiful cathedral, which is the heart of the spiritual heart of the city of New York. And it's just wonderful to see all of the young people. I've never seen so many acolytes in my life in one place. And they bring a special joy to this celebration. And afterwards, you're going to come up and we'll take a nice photo. So look forward to that. And continue to bear witness to your faith. All who are here tonight, we have, each of us is given a mission to bring others to know the love of the Father found in fellowship, in friendship with Jesus, the Son of God. That's our vocation. We all share that vocation. So let us go forth tonight as missionaries, idente missionaries, to bring that love, to spread that love, and to give people the opportunity to find the peace that comes from a relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So thank you for your travels tonight. It wasn't easy driving here into the city. But hopefully you had good conversation and you stopped to get something to eat. So thank you. And to my brother priests who are members of the community or friends of the community, thank you for your presence here tonight, and for all the lay members, the consecrated women, to our lovely choir for leading us in worship tonight. Thank you for your presence, and also for the staff here. Father Andrew, Father Ryan, thank you for your assistance in helping us celebrate tonight so beautifully. Thank you. So, brothers and sisters, hermanos y hermanas, el Señor esté con ustedes. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the glory and joy of the saints, who has caused you to be strengthened by means of their outstanding prayers, bless you with unending blessings. Amen. Freed through the intercession of Saint Andrew, the first called, and formed by the example of his holy life, may you be ever devoted to serving God and your neighbor in charity. Amen. So that one day, together with all the saints, you may possess the joy of our homeland in heaven, where Holy Church rejoices that her children are admitted in perpetual peace to the company of the citizens of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
We now ask Brother Lois and Brother Joseph to bring the altar servers onto the sanctuary for a group picture with Bishop Mazza.
We sing, you know the Salve? You know how to sing it? They know how to sing the Salve, Regina? Should we sing it?
Thank you. Attention, ladies and gentlemen, this time the Cathedral of St. Patrick is now closed for the evening. Please exit in front of the building to your right. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this time the Cathedral of St. Patrick is closed for the evening. Please exit in front of the building to your right, located on 51st and 5th. We want to thank you all for your visit. God bless you. Stay home safe. Atención, damas caballeros, esta hora Catedral San Patricio está cerrada. Por favor, usa la salida frente al edificio de la iglesia, calle 51 y Quinta Avenida. Muchísimas gracias y que pase una buena noche. Once again, folks, the Cathedral of St. Patrick is now closed.